All over this room are miracles. There have been multiple wheelchairs empty over the past 74 days. Many of them you will see and hear from tonight. There have been amazing testimonies of what God has done. And it's not only what's been done here, it's what's been done around the globe by live stream. And they're with us right now. One such story came to me from Louisiana. A young lady that I'd heard her testimony on more than one occasion. Because this young lady has probably lived through one of the most traumatic experiences anyone could live through. A lot of people have been thrown away. A lot of people have been given up. And a lot of people just feel that way. This young lady contacted me because she is a two-time abortion survivor. And let me explain that. As a baby, she was aborted. Left to be thrown away in a trash can. And spared by a sovereign act of God. Years later in her life, she experienced a brutal rape. Already feeling unwanted, unloved, and uncared about, she conceded to have an abortion herself. Now living with the trauma of what should have happened to her, could have happened to her, and living with her own guilt, she bore the physical pain and even some physical infirmities from that. A Catholic girl who loved the Lord with her whole heart, once she found the Lord, she began to take real strong stands to see some laws change, and really was tremendously influential in changing the laws in Louisiana so that no fetus could ever be disposed of by being thrown away again, that they had to do verification. But watching live stream one night, standing right over here, a six-year-old little girl, Abigail, was here. And Abigail began to be touched by the Holy Spirit. Literally a six-year-old, the power of God fell on her. And Brandi was home watching by live stream. And something went off in her and she got touched with the Holy Ghost. The Holy Ghost just overtook her in her room. And she contacted me immediately and she said, after all I've been through, watching that six-year-old for the first time, I felt valuable. And I got free for the first time. Now, she's been used all over the country. Some of the greatest fundamental platforms in our country, some of the greatest right to life movements in our country. She said, I did all of that, but it was almost guilt driven. I was doing it to try to make up for something, but still didn't feel valuable myself. But now I feel valuable. Ladies and gentlemen, would you meet Brandi Lozier from Louisiana, who's here with us tonight, and is a testimony of what God can do in an instant. You ought to do better than that. Brandi hasn't missed a thing at this meeting. She stays glued to the live stream and she calls and updates me every 10 minutes. Lets me know what's happening in her life. But the little girl standing right there at 6 years old caused her to have an encounter with the Holy Spirit. Two-time abortion survivor, Catholic girl, now overtaken in love with the power of the Spirit, and sitting here tonight, not just healed, but sitting here whole. And look at here, there's the little girl. Oh, somebody ought to give God some glory up in here. There's the baby responsible. Look at Abigail. When Abigail got it right there, Brandi got it at home because she started putting some pictures together. And there's a two-time abortion survivor. Aborted herself, survived it, had one and dealt with the trauma of it, found the Lord, true to her Catholicism, then started serving the Lord in fundamentalism, but found wholeness when God touched She wants a picture. Got a camera? We don't care, do we? Here. Let her have it. I think she ought to get one. My, my, my. Let her have a picture. Isn't that beautiful?